Hello everyone, my name is Alexander Makaveev. I am a product analyst at one CI company, and today I'll demonstrate you how our one C drive product can account manufacturing overheads in production companies. And we will go through settings, and we'll see example of data preparing and examples of documents in one C drive as well, including manufacturing overheads. So let's start from first slide. We have to define some data to prepare indirect cost settings. Actually, we have developed normal costing in one C drive. It means that we can include overheads and finished products costs by planned costs, planned indirect costs, and we can adjust those amounts by month and closing procedure, and adjusted by difference between actual cost and planned cost of period. So in by this methodology, you have to define planned indirect cost firstly. And I would like to demonstrate you example how it's can be done. In my example, I have got two departments. It's sausage workshop and packing workshop. And I can estimate costs of that I spent by those departments. I can discover it by cost items or just find total amount somehow. In my example, I will use department allocation methods, and you could use company allocation method as well. So if you use company allocation method, you don't have to divide your costs by production departments. But I will show you this kind of methods in one C drive, how it works. And we have estimated costs. It costs by months. And when we're done with that, we go to the next step. And we have to define cost driver. Cost driver, it's a way how to measure base of allocation, for example, labor hours or machine hours. It's a way how we will allocate our costs to finished products that we produce during the period. Let's go to our file again and see how it works. I found that the most suitable base will be machine hours and for sausage workshop and labor hours for packing workshop. It means that I need to find those costs, how many hours averagely machine works in this department in sausage workshop, and I found that my workers spent 200 hours per month in packing workshop. So that's data that I will use as a base of cost allocation, and I will show you how it works a little bit later. So let's go to our presentation again. we have to create cost drivers for cost drivers and systems and cost pool as well. So I have already done that. I put labor minutes and machine minutes in the system, and also I have entered cost pools, it's the name of cost pool, and it's mapped with cost driver as well. And I have to define cost allocation base, for example, number of labor hours, number of machine days. We have already done with it. I just have shown this to you. And after that, we have to define cost allocation base per operation. we go to operation settings in 1C drive for that. So it's production operations. We have two operations in here, and we put those amounts in standard workload field. For packing operation, it's 6 minutes. It takes 6 minutes of labor minutes to prepare this operation. And for Canadian, it takes 60 machine minutes to prepare this operation. So I just set up this, and when I enter a bill of materials, this data, and choose operations in the routing tab, this data come here as well, and I can adjust it if I need it, but I don't need it in here, and just save and close bill of material with this operation and these settings. And also I have to define cost allocation rate. It's in my case, it's a cost of 1 minute, cost of 1 minute labor hour or machine hour. I go to manufacturing overheads rate. And in my example, I have departmental allocation methods. It's a setup in my accounting policy. I can show you this department allocation, manufacturing overheads allocation methods. I have chosen department allocation one. That's why I have two lines in here, and I set up setup rates for sausage workshop and packing workshop as well. I choose cost drivers, different cost drivers, and different accounts for that as well, because I will collect actual amounts by each department separately. And I set up rates. How I found rates, I can show you. That's I have a total amount of costs per month, and I have machine hours, so I can found how much cost 1 machine minutes in here, and how much costs 1 labor minutes in here by the formula. So I just put it in our system in here, and it seems like we are done with those settings, and now we can go to our process, and I will show you how it works, and how we can manage online costing with our costing overheads method. So let's start production operation. How we can start production operation actually? We have to generate, we have to enter a production order firstly. I entered with vegan sausage. With 2 pieces of that. After that, I have to generate work in progress documents. I've got 2 production stages in 2 departments bill of material data. I have to make a vegan fill-in firstly, and after that, I make vegan sausages. And I have already generated work in progress documents. Let's see those documents. So I would like to start this. I would like to start this work in progress. I turn it to in progress status and post it. No, I can't. I have to set up main warehouse because I've got vegetables and spices over there. Post this document. And I'm done with this step, start of production operation, and cost of components are traced directly into cost object right now. And after that, I have to finish production operation. I can do it like this and post it. It means that our operation with this workload rate and total, actually total is 2160. The operation with this total will come to our work in progress register and one work in progress report. I can show you this. We see this operation and it costs 21.6 euro. And after that, we can generate a production document to release our semi-finished product. We will release it to Sausage Workshop. We can see that our costs went out by outflow. And now we have to complete another one. Let's set up Sausage Workshop in here. And generate production document as well. Oh, sorry. So now we can see that we produce some goods. We can see cost of that. We prepared vegan filling. It's our semi-finished product, and we can see cost of that. And we can see that this cost was calculated from components cost and operation cost. It's our planet overheads cost in here. And we can see vegan sausages. We pack it from vegan filling. And we can see that this cost of this same thing product come to component costs. And also we have packing operation costs in here. And this packing operation costs, it's our planned overheads for this operation as well. We can see trial balance in here. And we can see that it's our planet costs. It's and in here it's in debit of those accounts. It's actual costs, and we have differences in here. And by our scheme, so we have done this product release. We didn't sell of product yet, but anyway, it will come to COGS when we sell it. And during the month and closing procedure, we have two options. I will show you. It's in our accounting policy, how we can do with that, with differences. So we can apply adjusted allocation rate to our products, or we can just write off those difference to COGS account. So if we apply adjusted allocation rate, how it was in here, and if we close the period, it's September right now. So we will see that we don't have leftovers in this accounts. And we can see a report like this, for example, and we can see that those amounts were adjusted. We can see it by documents. that's months in closing, adjust costs of work in progress, and adjust cost of finished products as well. Because it's outflowed in here, and come to another report. We can see it in another report, like a stock statement, for example. Oh, sorry. Have to enter right period in here. So we can see vegan sausages in here, and we can see that months and closing procedure adjust cost of our sausages, that is closing balance of that. We didn't sell anything yet, but we can see that our closing balance amount of those sausages was changed. So now when we sell it, it's adjusted cost will be moved to COGS account. If we choose another method of an accounting policy as a difference as assigned to COGS example, we can see another picture. Let's do it. I just change it to write off to cost of goods sold in here. And let's close our period again. Let's see trial balance. Trial balance is, we can see that those accounts are closed again, but we can see income summary in here. It's our loss in here, because difference will come to COGS, and COGS will this account was closed by months and closing procedure, and the balance of this account was moved to income summary. And we couldn't see months and closing documents here anymore because we don't adjust finished products that we produced in the period. That's two options how we can adjust our differences from planned costs up to actual costs. That's it. Thank you for attention.